Hi guys, my name is Ian Crew. I'm an instructor at the Joy of Dance Center in Toronto, Ontario, and the creator of socialballroom.dance, where you can learn your dance at your place on your schedule. We've talked recently about the regulars at a dance social, the ones who have the most experience, the ones everyone wants to dance with, because they always seem to have the most fun dancing with them. Now, the reality is that unless you're already friends with someone in this elite group, you're not going to get accepted overnight. But there are things that you can do which can gradually make you more visible to them so that they're more likely to ask you in the future. Now, one thing that you can do, and I know that I've said this before, but it's worth repeating, go to the same social on a regular basis. First of all, you're getting repeated exposure to them, and they to you, so they can see that you're dedicated to dancing, you're not just passing through. And second of all, it's just good practice. If you commit yourself to coming in for one evening a week, that allows you to improve on your social dancing abilities. I like to say that social dancing is a skill to be learned like anything else. Now, there is a way to fast track things a little bit if you have a little more experience. One thing that you can do is start dancing with beginners and then throughout the evening work your way up to more and more experienced dancers. So with that beginner dancer, you want to acquit yourself, pull out some decent moves, but you're going to stay within your partner's comfort zone. Make sure that they have a good time. That way you attract the attention of other people who see that not only do you look good, you're making the other person look good too. And they're going to want to enjoy a similar kind of dance with you. So you can then dance with somebody who's a little more experienced. And now you can pull out a little more technique to draw the attention of somebody who's the next level up. And in this way, throughout the evening, you can gradually work your way up the ladder until you are either at the top of your dancing ability or you are dancing with some of the most experienced dancers there. Either way, you're guaranteed a pretty good time. If you're trying to grab the attention of somebody in this upper level dancing group, you're gonna wanna position yourself so that you can either ask or be asked by them earlier on in the evening. The fact is, you're less likely to score a dance with them once their friends arrive. So if you can talk to them earlier on in the evening, they're a lot more likely to say yes to you. And keep them in the corner of your eye when you're dancing or if you're off the floor so you can jump in and ask them as soon as the song ends before someone else gets there. That might seem a little bit desperate, but generally in the ballroom dancing world, it's considered fairly natural for people to jump up and ask as soon as they can. And by the way, regardless of whether you're a man or a woman or a leader or a follower, I don't see anything wrong with going out and asking another person to dance. I've seen so many people, usually women, who sit frustrated throughout a night because they're hoping that another man is going to come up and ask them to dance. The fact is, this is not a very empowering behavior. You're basing your happiness off of whether someone else is going to ask or not. I say take the power back, get out there and ask some people to dance. If you get rejected, you can just do what the rest of us do. You just smile, thank them, move on. It's not personal. Now, if you do manage to get a dance of one of these dancers, it goes without saying that you should bring your A game. I mean, we'll talk more about this in a couple of weeks, but for now, just know that good dancing is about more than just pulling out all your best moves. It's about entertaining your partner. All the best dancers recognize that if their partner isn't happy, the dance as a whole is going to suffer. So show these elite dancers that you can speak their language, and they'll be more likely to want to dance with you in the future. Now, you might consider starting up a light rapport at the end of a dance. Something simple like, "That was great! Who do you learn from?" Now you can watch the response, gauge their reaction, see if they are interested in talking with you a little bit more, or if they're looking around for another partner or they're giving you one-word answers, probably best to just thank them and move on. But this gives you an opportunity to get to know somebody a little bit more. You might make friends with this whole group at the same time, or you might just meet and get to know one of these more experienced dancers. But ultimately, all you need to do is get to know one of them before they start introducing you to everyone else. If they start asking you what other socials you go to, or maybe invite you to join them for a snack or a drink after the social, it's a very good sign that you're starting to become accepted into this group. And by the way, you're going to sometimes encounter groups of people who are too cliquey. You know, the fact is some more advanced dancers are not always very supportive of the social dancing atmosphere. They will only dance with other friends of theirs, or maybe they'll only dance with people who are on the competitive circuit. And there's not a whole lot you can do about that. If that group of people comprises the whole upper level of dances at this social, you might want to consider changing venues. I know that's frustrating. The good news, though, is that most dancers at that level aren't that cliquey. They are more accepting of dancers who have a little less experience because they recognize that a beginner dancer is just another challenge to overcome. So look for clubs and dance halls where people are a little more inclusive, where you see more exchanging of partners, and that will give you some idea about how welcoming they are to people who are looking to dance around and meet different people. But those are some tips that can help you network and meet the right people and get the dances that you want to get, mostly through things that you can do off the dance floor. In a couple of weeks, we'll talk about things that you can do to be a more entertaining dance partner so that people will want to dance with you more frequently. But next week, we'll talk to another student and how she went from being a social dance wallflower to a social dancing butterfly. So I look forward to seeing you then. If you had any questions about today's video, you can message me on my Facebook fan page, Ballroom Dancers Anonymous, or you can email me at ian@socialballroom.dance. Again, that's ian@socialballroom.dance. I look forward to seeing you then, and until then, happy dancing.